position, axis, size, symmetry, and squeeze. Pulmonary aorta and supraluvina level. Position, alignment, and size. Four chamber view is basic cardiac examination. And normal fetal heart occupies one third of the chest. In normal four chamber, there are two atria and ventricle, two valves with offset, and one interventricular septum. In general examination, we have to see position, axis, size, symmetry, and squeeze, and there should be no pericardial effusion. In atria, both atria should be of equal size, atrial septum primum must be present, and foramina ovale flap opens in left atrium. Both ventricles should be of equal size, without wall hypertrophy, with presence of moderator band in right ventricle, and intact interventricular septum from apex to crux. Both valves open and move freely, mitral and tricuspid, and there is a normal offset. No pericardial effusion with normal wall thickness and equality of both atria and ventricle. In atria, there is presence of septum primum and foramina ovale. Normal offset of mitral and tricuspid are seen with all four chamber anatomy illustrated. There are three steps to look for cardiac axis. A normal heart deviates about 45 degrees towards left. Ideal age of fetal echocardiography is 18 to 20 weeks and should be examined in high contrast. Zoom the image is an integral part of fetal echo to examine detailed anatomy and always use harmonics. Decreasing angle of image acquisition increases the frame rate from 20 to 58 hertz. For normal situs, first put probe over fetal head. See for synchronicity between probe and machine. Move probe towards fetal heart. Usually heart occupies left side of the chest. See for stomach bubble, which is on the left side of heart. See for IVC on right side, and establish situs of heart in just a single swing. After establishing the situs, we have to look for three chamber view, and that is the only way you need to examine the fetal heart, and it is the best way you can see, and thymus is always coming in bonus. This is AIOEM guideline that you can see four chamber, then LVOT, then RVOT, and ultimately you will go for three vessel trachea view. I am surpassing these two tabs of LVOT and RVOT. Just go from four chamber view directly to the three vessel trachea view, four chamber to directly to three vessel trachea view, and you can find almost 96% of the anomaly which you can name in congenital heart disease. According to the way, which the way you cut the heart, either transversely, you can see pulmonary aorta and supravena cava, and this is the typical three vessel view. You can have a different ductal arch like this. If you cut at this level, you can have a pulmonary aorta and supravena cava. You can have a very good aorta or ductal arch looking in this way. This is a Dadaji's stick. This is aortal arch view. If you see the ductal arch, it is a hockey stick view. So this three vessel tracheal view is utmost important in examining the fetal heart, and you can have a very good pulmonary aorta and supravena cava, and this you can see in postmortem picture. This is a typical three vessel view, and believe me, this thymus is coming always in bonus. We are not looking at the thymus. So what we have to see, or what is the checklist is there in three vessel tracheal view? Always see pulmonary aorta and supravena cava, they are always decreased in size, and it is from the right or left. Thymus is visualized and it is in bonus, and if you put color, it is seen either in blue or red, or it is inverted. Sometimes we can see the fourth vessel, that is persistent left superior vena cava. Typical three vessel view, you can have an inverted V-shaped cover, thymus is coming in bonus, either blue or red according to your color scale. You can see this flow going towards the spine. Always follow the aorta. Once you follow the aorta, LVOT, then say next view will become the pulmonary, and then third view will be coming is the pulmonary, aorta, and supravena cava. This you can find at 13 week of gestation. Typical crossing vessels, pulmonary is always last. I say always follow the aorta, then you can go for the pulmonary artery, then triple vessel tracheal view, 3VT view. That is the most important view after the four chamber. Why we want to design this view? Because if you see there is abnormality in the size or shape or number or alignment or course or discontinuation or turbulence or there is a reverse flow, anything you can see in this three vessel tracheal view will guide you that there is something abnormal lying there, particularly in coarctation of aorta. You can have this like this, hypoplastic left heart, no color filling. Same in hypoplastic left heart, you can see no color filling in the left heart on small aorta. Because of this coarctation of aorta, you can have a shelf-like structure over this. Double aortic arch, pulmonary stenosis, pulmonary atresia, you can have a retrograde flow. You can see pulmonary stenosis in tetralogy of Fallot. Typical pulmonary stenosis is seen in the three vessel tracheal view. You can see pulmonary stenosis with small pulmonary artery. You can see all this thing in TUI, and this is very good advantage of higher end machine that they can put you in TUI mode. Pulmonary atresia is very well seen with small pulmonary arteries, same pulmonary atresia with small pulmonary artery. This all are three vessel tracheal view. You can have a dilated pulmonary artery, and you can have a turbulent flow if there is absent in the pulmonary valve. In TGA, you can have a convex aorta and supravena cava. TGA is just convex course of aorta and supravena cava. Both vessels running parallel, this is normal, and you can see two vessels are running parallel in transposition of great artery. Always there is a normal size of great vessel, size is not disturbance, but you can have a two parallel vessel and you can diagnose at 13 week of gestation also. This is a convex shape of aorta in two vessel TGA. If you see dilated vessel like this, this is a common atrial trunk. Rather than three vessel, you can see one dilated vessel. So it is a case of common atrial trunk, and it is also very well seen in three vessel tracheal view. This is a color of common atrial trunk, and you can see two vessels flowing there. Double outlet mitral, you can have a Y-shaped vessel rather than pulmonary aorta and supravena cava. And all this anomaly, right aortic arch and left ductus arteriosus. This is the case of right aortic arch. Here you have to see at the level of trachea. Trachea is denominator. If trachea is lying outside this, you can have a right-sided aortic arch. If trachea is lying in between, then you have a right aortic arch with double ductus arteriosus, left ductus arteriosus. This is typical pulmonary artery, aorta, and trachea is lying in between. And SVC you can see over there. This is a, you can call it a sphenoid U sign, loose vascular ring when there is right aortic arch. This is tracheoesophageal TOF, and you can have a pulmonary ASD with trachea is lying in between. This is double aortic arch. You can have a trachea is the denominator. This is left, this is right, and this trachea is lying in between. Typical double aortic arch, pulmonary aorta and supravena cava. Here you say two arch. Again, there is trachea as the denominator, and you can have a two aortic arch lying over there. Typical color nomograms is visualizing all the things. Recently, we are watching the fourth vessel. Usually, left superior vena cava has to be absorbed and become the ligament of Marshall. But when it is not there, you can save the fourth vessel in triple vessel view, that is LVAC or left superior vena cava. This is LVAC, and you can see as a fourth vessel in high resolution machine. Same in total anomalous pulmonary venous connection, there are four types, cardiac, supracardiac, cardiac and intracardiac, and combination of all. You can see fourth vertical vein which is going like just near to the pulmonary artery, and there is a total anomalous pulmonary venous connection. Then question arises, how we have to differentiate between these two? If there is left superior vena cava persistent, then we have an enlarged coronary sinus and absent left retrocephalic vein. But in case of total anomalous pulmonary venous connection, we have only normal sinus. Sometimes fourth vessel we can see as a ductus arteriosus aneurysm. This is pulmonary aorta superior vena cava, and this is ductus arteriosus as an anomalous, and you can have a turbulent flow in ductus arteriosus aneurysm. Nowadays, all fetal medicine specialists able to find the aberrant right subclavian artery. You can call it as aberrant subclavian artery, you can call it as a retroesophageal artery, or you can call it as a Lussier artery. And this artery is very well seen in triple vessel view, the three pulmonary aorta and supravena, and this ursa, and ursa has got rightly from, and this is trisomy 21. Why ursa has got utmost important? Because normally ursa is found only in 1% of the euploid fetus, where it is found in more than 24% of trisomy 21 with likelihood ratio of 3.9. So when we see ursa, we have to subject all our patients for chromosomal analysis. If they are early, you can advise them NIPT, and then later you can go for karyotype. As I am mentioning that thymus is always coming in bonus. This is a three vessel tracheal, pulmonary aorta and superior vena. Just like umbilical vein is coming in bonus when you are sampling umbilical artery. Likewise, thymus is coming in bonus. So there is a very good paper published in journal in 2011 that you have to see thymic thoracic ratio at the level of triple vessel or pulmonary aorta and supraaorta. Sometimes small thymus, sometimes absent thymus. You can measure this thymic thoracic ratio at brachiocephalic way, and believe me, this measurement is very easy once you identify the left brachiocephalic vein, or you can measure it in a three vessel tracheal view also. This measurement of at the level of brachiocephalic vein and this measurement done at the level of three vessel tracheal view. Cutoff is 0.44. If it is more than 0.5, you have to think of some cardiac anomaly. And with this simple brachiocephalic vein and cardiothoracic ratio, imagine all these congenital anomalies we are able to diagnose with this simple brachiocephalic vein and thymus thoracic ratio. This is left brachiocephalic vein, you have to take as a denominator, and with this you can have a very good identification. Then Manish is saying that three vessel tracheal view is important. Not like that. The paper published in 2010, they had studied of 106 fetuses with congenital heart disease, and believe me, they found 75 patients, they have got abnormal three vessel tracheal view, and out of them 91. You imagine all this cardiac anomaly and you can find this abnormal three vessel tracheal view. So in my opinion, three vessel tracheal view is most important ultrasound view, easy to obtain, and we can find it very well, and it is very easy to do with rotational and technique. Rotation technique of ECHO is used when IVC is perpendicular to ultrasound beam. Rotate the probe until LVOT is seen. In sweep technique, angle the probe cephalate from four chamber view towards three vessel view, that is pulmonary, aorta and supraavena cavity. From four chamber, move probe towards the fetal upper mediastinum to see three vessel view, that is pulmonary, aorta and supraavena cavity. Dash dot dot. Only four chamber view rule out 65% of CHD, while combined four chamber and three vessel view gives sensitivity of 81% and specificity of 99%. Put color to see flow either in blue or red in inverted V shape. Three vessel view is an orthogonal view of fetal upper mediastinum, where main pulmonary, ascending aorta and SVC are arranged in straight line and size in decreasing order, just like dot dot dash. If we put color, we will see inverted V sign. In doing fetal echocardiography, four chamber and three vessel view doesn't require hard end machine. We can do and practice it on simple 2D machine with cardiac setting. So PASVU is most important view in fetal echo, and it is easy to obtain, especially in early gestation. All anatomical landmarks are easy to identify and master, and in all major CHD, three vessel view is always effective. In tetralogy of Fallot, if we see three vessel view, there is large ascending aorta and small pulmonary vessel. In ventricular disproportion, we see a small ventricle in four chamber view. In transposition of great vessel, we are watching two parallel vessels coming out from both ventricles. I am very much thankful to all my teachers, those who have taught me ultrasound. So Professor Abu Ahmed, Professor Robin Chovi, S. Suresh, Campbell, and thank you madam for giving me opportunity. Believe me, it's very simple to do four chamber view and triple vessel. It won't take much of your time. Only 4% is the cardiac anomaly, but the 4% is too high if mother and family has to bear the congenitally abnormal child. So at the end, everybody should be happy in our field. Thank you very much.